Now we had defined our enterprise structure. Now we had defined the control for the distribution side. The next step is to define or create the physical stores. Okay, to create the stores, unlike in classic core modules where we create the plans in the IMG section, here we have to create them in the easy from the easy access screen. However, when you are saving that, it is going to create a transportation request site create. So let me create W005. So before creating a site physically, I want to show you the functionality of a site profile. So W100. Okay. Yes, just notice these things. One is the site profile W100. Here, just notice these two points. One is the customer and one is vendor. Okay. I'm not going to save it. Here you are getting only the customer. Okay. So what is that controls? That is controlled by this site profile. Okay. So before going into the site profile, we'll see what is the distribution center and what is a store. Distribution center is, as the name suggests, is like a head office or regional office. Okay. So what does the regional office do? And the stores are something that are selling the material to the end customer or the consumer. Okay. So the stores are scattered across the country and you can have multiple stores on a city. Okay. But what is a distribution center? Distribution center is a head office or regional office. So a group of stores will have one regional office, that is the distribution center. Okay. So the functionality of a distribution center is to buy the materials, is to take care of the requirements of the individual stores, which means they will collect the requirements from the stores, consolidate, and they will procure the material from the external vendor and send it to the stores. So in this process, you could see that the distribution center is acting as an internal vendor for the stores and customer for an external vendor. So that is the reason when you are creating a distribution center, you are getting the buttons customer as well as vendor. So you are creating both customer master as well as the vendor master for the distribution center. When I try to create a store in the second screen, so you notice that there was only one button, that is the customer, which means the store is performing the role of a customer only. The store is performing the role of a customer to the internal vendor, that is the distribution center. Yes, it can act as a customer to the external vendor also, provided the stores are given the authority to raise purchase order by themselves and send it to the vendor, external vendor, and receive the materials directly from the external vendor. Okay, so that is the reason when you are creating the distribution center, you create both customer master and vendor master. And when you are creating a store, you are creating only the customer master associated with that. Okay. How does this store, when you are creating, how does the system know that you are creating a customer, distribution center, so that you have to create a customer and vendor for that? Or you are creating a store so that you have to create only the customer master for that? That is controlled by this site profile. So you have to configure your site profile before you start creating your sites. Okay. To configure the site profile, you go to the SPRO screen, IMG, Logistics General, Plant Master, Control Data, Site Profiles. So before going to site profile, we see what is a copy rule. Okay. The addition of stores or plants in retail it's much more rampant than what is being done in the standard modules like sales and distribution or materials management. So there what happens is, like, at the time of implementation you define the new stores, and so what are all the plans available, okay? And post implementation there are slim chances of frequent addition of the plans, okay? But in retail it's not like that. Wherever, like, you will be seeing the marketing up the market opportunities, and you will keep opening the stores then and there, okay? So which means you will be creating so many sites or plants. Okay, you will be creating so many sites. When I say sites, it can be either distribution center or store. You will be creating so many sites so that you want to reduce the time in setting up the store in the system level. Okay, so when you're creating a site, what you can do is, like, you can copy an existing site or a reference site and have the values pre-populated. Not only that, you can also reference the data, like your planning data, your history data and everything, from a store that is already existing. For example, if you are opening a store in a locality where another store is there, okay, you need not wait for this store to build its own sales history or planning data so that you can start planning for that. Now, instead, since the store is going to be similar to the existing one, you can reference or you can copy the planning data and the replenishment data, history data, everything from the existing store. So what are the data you want to copy when you are copying an existing store? That is controlled by this copy rule. So what does a copy rule contain? It's a two-digit alphanumeric code and has the tables. So when you are copying a site, the system will copy the data from these tables, okay, whatever tables are there, from these tables of the existing site to the newly create site, I mean to the new site that is being created, okay. So what we can do is, like, we can copy the existing copy rule and you can make the changes. For example, like, if you don't want to create, I mean you don't want to copy the stock planners, you might want to define new stock planners specific for these stores, okay, you need not copy that, okay. So you have to define the copy rule first. So I have copied the system predefined copy rule and I had made my changes and I had saved it as my Woolworths copy rule. We come to the site profile. This is what the actual control is. A site control contains details like, what is the store category? Okay, I have created three site profiles, one for distribution center, one for stores and one for department stores. Okay. See, whenever you are creating a site, the system has its category, whether it is a distribution center or a store. There are only two categories and you will not be able to add more categories to this, okay? So this is, whatever site you are creating with this site profile, it is a store, okay? And it is a customer also. So when you are creating a customer master, you know that you will be defining the account group. Like in sales and distribution, we use 0001, 0001 for sold to party, 0002 for shipped to party. Okay, similarly, there is a account group for distribution center 0100 and there is a account group for vendor also 0100. What is an account group? Account group is nothing but a control for the fields in the master, in the master data. For example, you might want to have certain fields as mandatory or certain fields as optional, and you don't want to display certain fields. You don't want to confuse the customer, like, with so many fields. So you can suppress the fields that are not going to be useful for you. Okay, so those kind of things are controlled by the account groups. I will give you the link for the creation and maintenance of account groups. That video is not created by me, that is already existing in the YouTube. So you can refer that for the account group definition. So here, coming back to site profile, so site profile controls what is the category of the site which you are going to create based on the site profile, and what is the account group for customer master and vendor master. And here comes the reference data. It is always good to define a reference date, reference site in your site profile, because whenever you are creating a site, the system will try to copy the data from the reference site, which means like the maximum of data should be taken from the reference site, so that you need not spend much time on manually keying in the fields. Okay, and this is the copy rule that we had just seen. So which controls what data should be copied from the existing plant. And like we had seen, when you are creating the plant, the system creates customer master as well as the vendor master. So what should be the reference data for the customer master and vendor master? Okay. Next one is the classification. This is purely optional. The next two are purely optional. To be really frank, everything other than this control are optional. Okay, but the more you maintain, the more the less data maintenance work you have to do. Okay. Yes. This classification. Okay. So you can have different classification, like this is the set of site, or this is a set of material, this is a set of customers. Okay. I had defined a group so that whenever I create a new distribution center, it will automatically add it to the distribution center allocation group. If I don't maintain this, what happens? I will create this site. I have to manually add this site to that group at a later point of time. So instead of that, if I maintain this, the system will automatically copy this whenever I create a new distribution center. The same, if I go to the store profile, what I could see? In the store profile, I could see the site category is A. That is the store. And we have only the customer role for the stores, because it is a customer to the internal vendor as well as the external vendor. So that is the reason you have the account group for customer, and there is no vendor account group. Okay. And similarly, I have created a reference store and a copying rule. Since I'm going to create only the customer master, I have a reference customer and the organizational details. And you could see that I have assigned a different distribution channel, W2. W2, that is the retail. I'm differentiating this by saying that this is a retail specific. Similarly, I had created a group of class type 030, saying that this is a group of stores. Okay. The distribution center is going to be the same. Only thing is, like, the site category is A, that is store, but the customer account group is 120, that is, like, it will have a different set of fields that are made as mandatory from the other regular stores. Okay. See, in the earlier one, what happened? I have the store name itself as the customer name. Okay. But in this case, there is a difference. This is because of the number range assignment to the account group. What happened was, like, of course, I have corrected it later. What happened was, like, the number range assigned to this account group was allowing only the numerals. No alpha characteristics, are there was no external number assignment. So when I created this site W200, system automatically assigned a numeric number or numeric code for the customer. Okay, so later I created a new store, I fixed the number range issue, and I created a new customer as W200. I will show you how we can change our reorganize the customer master that is assigned to a site. So these are all the controls that are there in a site profile. So I have created my own sites, okay, site profile, and based on the site profile, I'm going to create the site. So to create the site, I go to transaction code WB01 W005. I'm using the number convention, all W00s for the distribution centers, W1 for the stores, W2 for the department stores, and W3 for the shops. So my W00 series, with the moment I see the name, I can find out easily that it is a distribution center, W005, and I want to create it as a distribution center. Okay, if by accident you have created a store, you wanted to create a distribution center but you ended up creating a store, you will not be able to change the site profile. What happens if I don't give the reference site? System asks whether it can pick the reference site from the site profile. If you remember what is the reference site I had given in the site profile, it is WRDC. Yes, the system automatically picks WRDC from the site profile. Since I had maintained a reference site, it is picking everything from the reference site. Don't ask why, when did Sydney move to Germany? Because since my company code is in Germany, I'm maintaining the country as Germany and currency as Euro, but I'm maintaining the physical addresses from the Australia one. Okay, so this is the what are the controls when you want to calculate your revaluation based on your retail price, and this is the listing. We'll come to these tabs whenever we come to this, we go through these concepts of listing and distribution profile, maintaining the distribution profile, and inbound and outbound profile for POS, point of sale solution, assigning the layouts. Okay, we will come to that, but our main intention is to create a site master and maintain the customer master and vendor for the distribution center. So I click the customer. Since I had given the reference customer in my site profile, so it is picking from there. All I have to do is like enter. Make sure that these fields are populated when you are creating. What happens is like if you are not maintaining these things in your reference, in your site profile, you will get only the customer number and the rest of them will be blank. So you will end up creating only the general data of the customer, not company code data and the sales area data. So to make sure that, you have to enter the sales organization, distribution channel, division for this. I need not maintain anything. I just keep pressing enter. Yes, the customer is created and you could see the customer number as W005. Now let me create a vendor. The same thing, you have to enter the company code and purchase organization. If you feel like you want to maintain any of the data, you can always maintain, but it is not mandatory. So now I have created a vendor also for this. Okay, let me save this. At the time, the system is asking whether the classification of the reference site. The classification of the reference site is like, it is assigned to the group called DC allocation group. Okay, whether it, you want to copy that. No, at this moment, I don't want to copy. See, these are all the parameters. Plus means entries exist for the reference site. So I already have the PP planning, production planning periods for, and the coverage profile, warehouse costs, and shipping specific data for these. All these data are already there. So I need not create them separately for this newly created site. This copying rule is what controls. It fetches these data from the tables. Now I confirm. Yes, it creates. I have created the site 005. Similarly, I can create a store W10. I think I created 6 yesterday. W110. The same thing. So this is what is controlled by the account group. So only these fields are mandatory. The account group controls that these fields should be made as mandatory. Purchasing distribution. Here you couldn't see the distribution profile because this is a store category. So here you are not going to distribute the material anywhere from the store. So that is why you don't have the distribution profile. POS layout blocks, creating the customer master. Okay. Just keep pressing enter. It will take everything from this. Now a customer 106. The customer name and the site name are same. Okay. It can be different also. It's not mandatory that it has to be the same. It can be mandatory. It can be different also. But for easy identification and everything, it is better to have them same. So this name assignment should be controlled by your number range assignment for the account group 0100. Save it. No. I confirm it. Yes, it creates a transportation request. So now we had seen how to create a site profile and create the distribution center stores and department stores or whatever it is based on our site profile.